1839. I have arrived at the village of Altshack. It's a haven in the midst of a vast forest and the last stop before my final destination, Castle Brennenberg. It's late in the evening, and the outrider, who has been with the coach since Bremen, advised me to wait until morning before I venture further. I've arranged for a bed at Der Müller, the village's only inn, and am now waiting for the sun to rise. I try to sleep, but as I close my eyes, I see the men who fell victim in London. My fear and shame forces me to witness the same scenes over and over. They are dead because of me.
Hey Jeff, why don't you fuck off? Better be, because I don't have a fucking place to hide. Oh, come on. Well then. Fuck! the guy that voices Alexander.
I feel like I have fled the world and all its worries. Brandenburg is a majestic creation perched upon a forest-clad hill with towers reaching well above even the highest pine trees. Following the winding road leading to the gates gives the impression of discovering something forgotten, as if journeying with Marco Polo to the hidden Xanadu. Alexander, the Baron, is a peculiar but gracious man. He seems well-versed in worldly matters, and is not at all as eccentric as I assumed. My room is exquisite, and I'm confident that no hotel for miles could even hope to match it. As the sun sets on Brandenburg, its fairy tale varnish turns to an eerie gloom. Alexander's strange servants are never far away. They are a quiet lot, and their behavior could only be described as skulking. Alexander seems pleased by my presence. As he puts it, it seems like I got here just in time.
Open door and come on screen. Soldiers in here. Thank you. just, like, sit in the corner of a hallway, or is that a really bad idea? Can they hear you breathing? Okay. Which I'm about to hit, so...
Thank you.
cliff racers.
Alexander began to tell me what he knew. It seems like the orb I found casts a long and dark shadow. It's not only a powerful item, but a dangerous one. Simply by touching it, you invoke the powers within, and if you are too weak to control it, it will devour you. The shadow is a sluggish thing, lagging behind the wielder, killing anyone or anything in its path to reclaim the orb. I said I didn't care about its powers, and that I should throw it away. Alexander advised against this, as I'd still be a part of the path to the orb, and eventually suffer death. Having the orb, I would at least have the chance to fight back when the time came. I asked Alexander what he meant when he said he could protect me, and he answered that things can be done, but at a price.
So I get orb and fight monsters. Okay. I guess I should have opened that door across the hall first. Yeah. I can shit! Fuck! Move, Daniel, move!
It's too dangerous!
I'm telling Gabriel!
I
How far am I from you? Thank you.
Oh, fuck.
That was probably a bad idea. Acid on? Oh, I don't have acid yet. Fuck. Which way do I go, do you know? Thank you.
fuck?
time on the stream. Why didn't you tell me? God damn it.
So you used the great sewers as a means to transfer?
Yes, if they were built to divert water from under our spring, and are quite spacious. It seemed only natural to incorporate it into the overall structure. But we want to leave it. Not today. The following season. And when the spring runs dry, the damp tunnels produce a rather poisonous type of fungi. There is an antidote, of course, but we won't be bothering you today. Come, this way instead. We're almost there.